108, The Punishment for Empty Promises. Many there are who seek to exalt themselves by displaying their great knowledge, but the Blessed One is he who makes his mind barren for the love of God. St. Francis of Assisi. Bolasha was an enthusiastic scholar and became one of the most learned and erudite men in all of Punjab. For 40 years he searched indefatigably for the truth, reading countless holy books and scriptures, and conversing with innumerable pious and holy men. But not once during all of this time did he discover any teaching that convinced him it was the true teaching. One day he met a friend who had advanced a long way on the spiritual path. This man saw Bulasha's plight. "Brother, why do you break your head over all these books?" the man asked. "For you, it is all a waste of time. Go and visit Inayat Shah. It is possible that he may be able to help you in your search." Inayat Shah initiated Bulasha into the truth and became his master, his murshid. Bulasha was soon carried away with love for the Lord, and in his ecstasy and bliss, said things which the orthodox clergy did not approve of or endorse. To the priests, religion was a matter of rites and rituals, all outward ceremonies, of which they had never known the inner meaning. The priests discussed Bulasha's faults at great length. "Bulasha, you are guilty of heresy," they said, "for you say and do things that are not in agreement with our faith. Have you anything at all to say in your defense?" "Please listen carefully to what I have to say," Bulasha told them. "Then you may decide the case in any way you wish." "Very well," said the priests. "Speak out, and we shall listen." "What punishment," Bulasha asked them, "would you recommend for a person who keeps on promising that he will give you something today, then tomorrow, and then the day after, but who, even after 40 years, has given you nothing?" "Such a person should be burnt alive," they replied. "Then, my friends," said Bulasha, "all of you should be burnt alive, for you and your doctrines and dogmas have promised me the truth for 40 years, but you have not once been able to give me even the smallest glimpse of it." Struck speechless, the priests walked quietly away. Bulasha, filled with the great joy of those who know the truth, then said, "Stop gathering knowledge, my friend. All you need know is the one letter A. Look how much knowledge Satan acquired, and how his hearth and home burnt to ashes." Footnote: Aleph is the first letter of the Arabic alphabet, corresponding to A. In mystic poetry, denotes Allah, God, or the Word. End footnote.